Hi all. Today in the video there will be an overview of such a buck and boost converter. Its power is about 80 watts. I bought it on Aliexpress and today in the video I decided to show you all its pros and cons. Despite its power and versatility, the device has a compact size. He does not have his own case, since it is designed to be built into various power supplies. I received the converter in such a cardboard box. The sticker contains the marking and characteristics of the device. The device is packed in a bag of air bubble tape, and therefore it was not threatened with any damage during the transportation process. The device is small, cute, made in a plastic case. There are latches on the sides to embed it in any device. There are a lot of different parts on the back. The regulator is stepper, it does not have smooth rotation. In addition to rotation, the knob can be pressed. The cooler, which is installed on a small radiator, immediately catches your eye. It connects to the board with two wires through a connector. The good news is that it does not work constantly, but only after the current strength exceeds 1 ampere. The only bad thing is that the number of revolutions does not depend on the load. The fan rotates continuously at maximum speed. Next to the fan is a throttle with a diameter of 2 centimeters and a width of 7 millimeters. The wire is about 1 millimeter in diameter. All electrolytic capacitors on the board have low internal resistance. Also on the board are two LM358 op amps and a large low resistance resistor that most likely serves as a shunt. On the side there is a small terminal block and a sticker with the designation of the conclusions. I connected the wires to the terminals and now I will show the device in operation. I supply power to the device. The display shows two lines. The top one is voltage and the bottom one is current. On the left is the inscription OUT. This means that the output is now 0 volts. I press the knob and the load light comes on. At the same time, the signal LED with the inscription ON lights up. I press again and the output voltage disappears. Now the output voltage is 14.18 volts and the current is 98 milliamps. I rotate the regulator clockwise and the voltage slowly rises. If I press the upper left button, then the displayed parameters will change on the bottom line. Now it shows the current strength, then the power in watts. Ampere hours poured into the load for one working session and the operating time of the device. If you hold down the same button, then the parameters of the top line will change. Here you can see the incoming voltage from the power supply. And chip temperature. If you press the bottom button, then we will go to the menu where you can change the output voltage and maximum current. If you turn the knob, the voltage will also change here. But if you press the knob, the cursor will move over all 4 digits, and they can also be changed. Thus, you can immediately set a large voltage without making 1,000 turns with the regulator. If you press the button again, the cursor moves to the bottom line. Here, the maximum value of the current that will be at the output of the converter is set. A very handy feature in cases where you need to limit the current. It is acceptable when working with LEDs or with charging batteries. It will also reduce the likelihood of burning your homemade product if a short circuit suddenly occurs. If you hold down the bottom button, then we will go to the options. The first page is called Open. You can set either off or on. If set to on, then when the converter is turned on, its output will be the voltage that was last set. If set to off, then when turned on, there will be no power output. This is where low input voltage protection comes into play. If the voltage on the power supply suddenly drops below the specified value, the converter will turn off. On this page, you can set the maximum voltage limit on the inverter output. If you put here, for example, 20 volts, and then in the process of work you raise the voltage and accidentally exceed this limit, then the protection will work. Here, as well as on the previous page, the maximum value of the current strength is set. If you put 3 amps here, then after exceeding this limit, the device will go into protection. The power of the converter can also be limited from 0 to 82 watts. Here you can set the current limit given to the load. By default, the counter is disabled, but if you hold down the knob, you can enter parameters measured in ampere hours. You can also set a timer for the device to work. Range from 0 to 100 hours. The chip shutdown temperature can also be adjusted from 80 to 100 degrees. If suddenly it seems to you that the converter incorrectly shows the input voltage, then it can be calibrated. The same can be done with the output voltage and current. After this page, the options start again. Now let's see how the device behaves in practice. In the options, I set the minimum input voltage to 10 volts. If the voltage from the power supply sags, the device will turn off below this limit. The tester behind just shows the input voltage from the 12-volt power supply. The voltage at the output of the converter is 15 volts. A light bulb is also connected there. Slowly, I will reduce the voltage on the power supply. After the voltage has dipped below the specified one, the converter switches off after a short period of time. The display shows an error, for what reason an accident occurred. After the voltage on the power supply rises, the converter returns to normal operation. But what to do in the event that the voltage on the power supply is dropped, and it, or how not to restore it? To bring the converter back to life, you need to go into the settings again and put the input voltage below 9 volts. To do this, however, is a little difficult since an error indication is constantly displayed on the display. And in the process of all manipulations, the converter is constantly trying to start applying voltage to the load and then turning it off again. When I nevertheless did the impossible, I got into the options and set the voltage to 5.8 volts. The converter worked as expected. Output voltage protection works like this. Let's say in the options I set the maximum voltage to 15 volts. I return to the main menu. Now the output of the converter is 11 volts. I press the lower left button and try to raise the voltage. As soon as the voltage was above 15 volts, the converter turned off. In this case, it became 16 volts. But even if the voltage rises by 0.01 volts, the same thing will happen. To return everything to work, you just need to turn the regulator and reduce the voltage. The power to the load is turned off during the accident, and after the voltage is restored, we just have to press the button. Stabilization of the maximum current is very simple. Let's say we set 300 milliamps in the main menu. I close the wires and the current does not rise above the limit. At the same time, the red indicator lights up. If in the options I set the maximum current to 200 milliamps, and in the main menu I also set the current limit to 300 milliamps, that will be a completely different situation. The device shows an error because the maximum current threshold has been exceeded. In this case, there can be no talk of any stabilization of the current. The working time limit works like this. I set the limit to 27 minutes. The device has already worked for 25 minutes. At this point, I sped up the video by 10 times so as not to wait 2 minutes. As soon as the time limit exceeded 27 minutes, the device turned off. Further machinations do nothing to help. In order to reset the time counter, it remains only to turn off the power. If you do not change the counter settings, after 27 minutes, the inverter will also turn off. Now I will test the device for maximum current strength. The voltage is 14 volts and the current will be 5.1 amperes. I will load using an electronic load. Please note that there are losses on the wires. On the electronic load, the voltage slowly sags, and at the output of the converter, the voltage has not changed a bit. The current parameters also differ slightly. The device holds a current of 5 amperes perfectly. If you slightly increase the load, current stabilization is triggered and the voltage sags. If the load is reduced, everything returns back. Now I have set 20 volts at the output of the converter and now I will check it for maximum power. In this case, it is more convenient to put the output power displayed in watts on the second line of the display. When the load exceeded 82 watts, the device turned off. I reduce the load and press the regulator to reapply power. I increase the power and bring it up to 78 watts. The converter holds the declared power just fine, and the voltage does not even sag. Also, the converter can be used as a voltmeter by connecting it to various current sources. This thing is also very convenient to charge batteries. You just set the voltage in the converter to which you need to charge the batteries and wait for the batteries to charge. As I said earlier, Here you can observe how many ampere hours are poured into the load. And at the end of charging, we will find out the full capacity of the batteries. As you can see, the red LED on the panel lights up. This indicates that the batteries are charged with a stabilized current. After a few hours, when the batteries are charged, the voltage will rise to the specified value and the current will drop to zero. If, for example, the meter reads 1000 milliamp hours, then it would be wrong to assume that this is the full capacity of the batteries. As we remember from physics, efficiency is never 100%, which means that part of the given energy is converted into heat. When charging, the batteries will heat up, so their actual capacity will be less than 1000 milliamps. On AliExpress, this converter costs about $10. I think this is a great piece for the money, as it has the functionality of several devices and greatly simplifies the assembly of a laboratory power supply. I will leave a link to this device under the video. If you liked everything, put like, click on the bell. Subscribe to my channel, ask questions in the comments, if someone is interested in something, and goodbye to everyone.